A year and a half ago, DJI released the Power 1000. It was quiet, powerful, and we said it was the unit we didn't know we needed. Fast forward to today, we have the Power 1000 V2. This unit has faster charging, more power output, and it's still extremely quiet. But with all the power stations on the market today, is this the power station for you? So welcome back to Lab, where our opinions cannot be bought. DJI is still a relatively new player in the power station game, but it is a logical evolution of the DJI brand. And if they keep making power stations like the original 1000 and 500, which they used to launch into the market, they're likely gonna be here to stay. As always, we will leave links to this power station and any coupons that we can get to save you guys some money in the description down below, as well as our power station quiz. If you're not sure exactly what power station you need, it's a 30-second quiz, gives you an instant recommendation that we recommend to you based on your needs. Otherwise, before we get into everything that we like about this new 1000 V2 and the stuff that we don't, we're gonna hit you with a super quick spec teardown to get you up to speed on DJI's latest power station. First up, this thing passes the tiny baby lift test. It weighs 31.3 pounds. It still has a 1024 watt hour battery, and you can connect up to 5 of their expansion batteries, which gets you to 11.2 kilowatt hours of total battery capacity, which is pretty impressive. It's got a bigger 2600 watt inverter. In terms of getting power into this guy, you can charge it from a regular house outlet inside of your home at 1500-ish watts, which is more than you used to be able to do. And you can get up to 1200 watts of solar into this. DJI makes that part a little confusing. You need their solar slash or plus car charger thing. It's a 1.8 kilowatt adapter that gets a total of 1200 of solar into this. The additional 600 needs to be put in through 12 volts like a car socket. Weird, but 1200 watts means you could charge this with solar in less than an hour, which is huge. In terms of ports, you have an extra 2 120 volt house plugs on the front, which gives you a total of 4 now. You have 2 USB-A's and 2 USB-C's, and you only have 2 of these SDC ports. There's no other plugs and ports on this. I mean, there's the AC charging port. That's how you plug it into the wall in your house. Otherwise, there is no more ports. If you want to use 12 volt car socket, if you want to do solar charging, if you want to do expansion battery, everything else runs through these SDC port adapters right here, which we'll get into in a minute. In terms of the design of this, it's exactly the same as the Power 1000. It is super sleek. It's got nice handles. The design is all forward facing. There's no plugs on the side or back, which we really like. It's on brand with what you'd expect from DJI, and their screen is actually really nice. It's super bright, it's easy to understand, the colors and everything are great. The app is fine for this. It lets you turn things on and off from afar. It gives you access to a couple settings and things that you can't change directly from the unit, but it doesn't give you anything crazy. And right now, at the time of filming this video, it is $469 on Amazon. And if we can get a discount code for you guys, we will leave it in the description to help you guys save even a little bit more money. The first thing that we really like about this V2 Power 1000 is that they have added 2 more plugs to the unit. That was something that we didn't like about the original one. 2 plugs is just not enough. 4 plugs, and the fact that they have them kind of reversed, so if you have like a camera battery plugged into this one, it'll go up and it won't overlap the plugs underneath. The design of this, even though it's the same as the original one, is a good design. Like, it works really well, it's functional, and we really, really like the overall design and build quality of this power station. And it has a really fast UPS. So basically, if you have this thing plugged into the wall and then you have sensitive electronics like your computer or whatever running off of this, which if you have a DJI, you probably do. If the power goes out, you can use this as a UPS system to keep those devices on, and it switches over extremely fast. It was really good in our testing. There was no problems with it. So if you work on computers or something all day like we do, plug your computer into something like this and then plug this into the wall. If the power goes out, you don't lose where you're at. You don't hurt your computer at all. You're good to keep going. And the biggest thing that we like about this power station is the same thing that we liked about the original one, is it's very clear and easy to tell who this is built for. It's super, super quiet when you're using it. You can get it to make noise if you're running it like full tilt for a while and it really, really needs to cool down. But for the most part, if you're just running it in a room where you're filming or doing some stuff, there's power stations that we couldn't turn on right now while we're filming because you would hear the noise. So this is great for creatives, because if you had it over there running, charging some things, or even running lights, if you're on the go and you're trying to film something, this unit makes no noise, it won't interrupt what you're doing. It's really quiet, and we really like that. They also increased the size of the inverter on this, which is really nice. It's 2600 watts now and a couple extra plugs, which means that yes, you only have a 1024 watt hour battery, but if you needed to use this for some heavier loads, you can run quite a lot off of this small little power station, which we love because it means not only is it good for the creatives and charging your phones, drones, laptops, and electronics, stuff like that, but you could have tons of studio lights off this for a filming session, or you could run your fridge or toaster, coffee maker, anything like that while you're on the go or while your power's out, just because you already have this in your home, which is really, really big. That's what most power stations are used for. I think DJI is the only brand where you would get it and not just use it to keep the fridge on or take it camping or do something like that. And so that makes this a little bit more compatible with all those other brands, which we like. We were also pretty impressed with the results of this thing in our testing. It was 82% efficient in our testing, which is pretty good. We give anything over an 80% an A. It surged really well and it had an 18 watt idle consumption, meaning if you had something plugged into this that turns on and off periodically, or like a camera battery, stuff like that, that once it's full, it stops taking power, this unit will consume 18 watts just sitting there with the inverters on, giving you power, ready to use, but not using it. Which means if you just had this on in a power outage and you were using things that intermittently turned on and off, this would last you 2.5 days just idling, which is not bad. And the final thing we like is that one expansion battery triples your capacity when you buy it for this unit, which means your 2600 watt inverter is a lot more applicable. If you're trying to like scale your system, it's pretty easy. And right now, if you buy it, I think you get a free cart.
Something like that, yeah.
So we have the cart, it's pretty cool. You put the battery on it, this on top of the battery, wheel it around. It's a nice setup. First thing that we don't like about this unit though, there's no light. We talk about this all the time. If you have a power outage or a power station that can be used in a power outage, it would be great to have a light on it. It's also helpful if you're in a dark environment, you're camping, or there's a power outage. If you have a light across a unit and you can turn it on, you can actually see what you're plugging in. You don't need to also have your phone out, holding the flash, doing something like that. This is a heavy enough unit that people are probably gonna carry it with two hands. If you're trying to get up a set of stairs, you don't wanna also have to be fumbling a phone or go put on your headlamp first or something. Put a light on your power station, it makes everybody's life easier. We also don't love these SDC ports. I get it. It's cool that you can fast charge DJI equipment that you may already have. I understand why they did what they did. But these two ports, one of them is an SDC light, one of them is just an SDC port, are the only way that you can get all the accessories you need to make this a true power station, in our opinion. If you want to charge this with solar and have an expansion battery connected, you can't have a 12 volt car socket available. You only have two ports. Which is annoying because basically everything that this doesn't have directly on it requires you to use these ports. And those accessories are kind of expensive. The 1.8 kilowatt solar car charger adapter that I was talking about earlier is $329. Most power stations in this price range and size category have solar input directly on it. It's a little bit of a buzzkill. And then if you have the expansion battery attached and you want to run the solar into the expansion battery, both these ports are full. If you were running a 12 volt appliance, you have to unplug it. It's not the dream. And the last thing is just DJI's solar panels are insanely expensive. For a 100 watt folding panel and the $59 adapter that allows you to only put in the 100 watt panel, you're almost $1,000 on Amazon, which is like buying two of these units up front, which is insane. You can get 400 watt bifacial rigid panels for like $187. There's no need to be spending almost $500. It's insane. There's tons of other brands that make panels for significantly less. So while we recommend the unit, don't be buying DJI's panels. We think this unit is best for creatives or someone who's already in the DJI ecosystem. If you are familiar with their products, this thing feels and performs exactly like you would expect. There's familiar beeps and sounds, and it works to fast charge if you have things with the SDC ports already. It is a great unit and it's super quiet. If you're a creative, you probably love accessories. You can put this thing in a little traveling bag and bring it around and plug it in. It won't make any noise. It's a good unit. It's also, if that's not you, a good unit for someone who's looking for light home backup. If you're just trying to run your fridge and your Wi-Fi router and some lights for a power outage for half a day or almost a full day, this is still a good option for you. And if you buy it and decide you want a little bit more battery power than what you have, you can always get the expansion batteries, which makes it pretty good for like an entry-level home backup system. So we would, at the end of the day, recommend this unit, but let us know what you guys think. Otherwise, that's pretty much all we have for you guys today. We will catch you next time. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.